speak student.
Using multiplicative inverse to solve equations, a la Shmoop. Whenever there's a snowstorm, hailstorm, windstorm, sandstorm, or any kind of storm, your parents go a little crazy stocking up on canned goods.
You're fired.
Right now, the stack of cans in the basement is about 11 feet high. Its ceiling is 20 feet high. You could play basketball down there, if it weren't for all the hoarding.
That's a foul.
So if the tower of cans grows 3/4 of a foot each month, how many months will it take for all those canned beets and carrots to reach the ceiling? Here are your options. First, we need to write this out in an equation. Let's see if we can find a piece of paper and pencil in all this junk. Okay, so we'll describe this as the current height of the cans plus the growth rate, which is 3/4 of a foot a month, times number of months, for which we'll use m as the variable. Notice the clever first letter thing there.
Ooh.
Equals height of the ceiling, which is 20 feet. We're solving for number of months, so that value is m. Here's our finished equation. First, we need to subtract 11 from each side to simplify this thing. That leaves us with 3/4 m on the left and 9 on the right. In order to get rid of the fraction, we need to multiply each side by the inverse of the fraction. Inverse means to flip the fraction over, kind of like multiplying by its opposite. In this case, the multiplicative inverse would be 4 over 3. So multiply both sides by 4 over 3. That cancels out the 3/4 on the left, leaving us with m. Multiply 9 by 4 over 3 to get 36 over 3. Simplify that to get 12. And the answer is B. M equals 12. So, it looks like you have a year before your basement is totally full. Look at the bright side. If a disaster does wipe out your house, you can live in a can fort. Food and shelter in one convenient place.
He hates these cans!
Plus, you now have the invaluable survival skill of using multiplicative inverse to solve equations. We'll be at your place when disaster strikes.
Say what?
Subscribe to check out more equally fantabulous videos. You should see the subscribe button just below this one. If you're having trouble locating it, we recommend you watch our video, How to Find the Subscribe Button.